and fuel requirements, very beautifully pointed, and one of the in Rajesh's presentation, I think one of the best slides was the one which was dedicated to petroleum. Right now, we have 86% of our fuel consumption being met by petrol. And the entire petrol comes from the other countries. So if we are able to recycle 25% plastic waste, 25% biomass, and the rest of the carbon dioxide, we would become totally non-dependent on the petroleum sources. So that will not only live up to the concept of Atmanirbhar Bharat, but it will also become self-sufficient and domestically much more independent. And because, and third, of course, the health sector, where we already have started making a mark. And fourth is the climate concerns. We've already made, the Prime Minister in COP20 made the commitment of zero, net zero by 2070. And all this is going to take us in that direction, which will give us a place of esteem in the world arena. So that is going to be the advantage. And third, if you see it from the point of view of the priorities of the government, headed by Prime Minister Modi, this lives up to the concept of Atmanirbhar Bharat. This fulfills the concept of Make in India. And this also meets the concept of what Prime Minister gave, life for environment. So you can understand how many issues are being simultaneously addressed by this single initiative today, which it may not be easy to understand. And that's why we tried our best to propagate it as much as possible through different kinds of media, whether it is the print media or the electronic media, so that people could actually understand. But still, I think unless they start using it, it would not happen. And in a nutshell, what will happen in the days to come is that the global economy will stop depending on manufacturing sector. So this is going to be a huge paradigm shift. Is going to depend on the recycling processes. This is very strange. Now you depend, your economy depends on what you are growing, what you are manufacturing, what you are developing. Your future economy will largely depend on what you are wasting. As he showed, all those garments abundant on the banks of Ganga. Yeah. That is the wealth, which is not being realized by those who abandoned it. When they realize it 10 years later, they would regret. They would go looking for that. By that, somebody like Alka would have already retrieved and recycled it. So this is going to be a paradigm shift which is not actually easily realized today. But as I said, this is what is going to make the difference. And of course, our bioeconomy under this government has shown a very steep progressive rise. We were just $10 million in 2014. Today we are 137. So we've gone multiple times, more than 13 times. By 2030 we hope to be $300. Similarly, and I think we also largely owe this to the achievements of the Department of Biotechnology in the last 4 or 5 years, which was possible because the COVID pandemic happened. So I don't mean to say that the DBT wishes COVID to happen again, but as they say, every adversity is accompanied with a virtue. It came as an opportunity.
Welcome to K-Mall, a premium project by Kaleem Group. K-Mall is in the heart of Kolkata's electronic, garment and lifestyle hub, Khidirpur. K-Mall, which is designed as a world-class mall, is the outcome of endless effort of our experts, combined with modern superb techniques and new-age design. Book now